What's up, YouTube? It's FitzBro, and welcome to my first build order guide for the Delhi Sultanate post the winter update for Age of Empires 4. We know there have been a ton of changes for Delhi, and most of those changes have been nerfs to civilization, including the removal of Sanctity from the Dark Age research option. So your first research now has to be efficient production, and I was trying to think, how can I use this to my advantage to come up with some kind of push in the second age, particularly against a civ that received a lot of buffs and loves to turtle the Chinese. So one thing that changed for Delhi is you can now research technologies faster in the dark and feudal age. So my plan here is to age up as fast as possible, get that siege engineering in, and try to get a ram in his base. I'm going to have a graphic for this build order that you can follow along with that will be available in the Discord. I will leave a link below in the description. Go to the Discord, navigate to my build orders channel. It's up at the to the top left, and you can find this guide. Pull it up on a separate monitor or look at it on your phone or just take a quick glance at it, but it will aid you in pulling off the strategy. Okay, let's get into it. First thing you're going to do is train up a villager and put all your villagers to sheep with one going to a mosque. I'm going to be shooting to have 8 villagers on food and 3 on gold starting off. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to get these initial sheep and drop them back off. And you can shift click to your house with that villager that is building a mosque. There you go. Here comes my first villager. And that first villager, I like to come out and build a mill so I can get that wheelbarrow tech in queue. You can get wheelbarrow slightly faster now. And one helpful tip is you can split your villagers on the sheep and they will gather faster. There we go. Efficient production is in queue. You'll see we'll have that in just about 2 minutes. So by the time we hit the second age, we're already going to have that efficient production. You can even decide to go for some kind of dark age cheese with a bunch of pikes, whether you're trying to defend docks, siege his docks, go mess with the Mongols, whatever it might be. That's another option you can think about. Okay, so there we go. We have 8 villagers on food, and then I'm going to get that wheelbarrow in queue. The new villager will go out to the gold. There we go. I'm going to try to get this on the network. Let's see. Right there. Perfect. So he'll get that buff when I start researching the upgrade in the feudal age. From here, this is basically it. 8 on food. I'm going to sheep because this eliminates the walking time out to the berries, and we're just trying to maximize as the age up time, try to age up as fast as possible. Now, you'll notice we don't have any wood, so how are we going to get a lumber camp? We are going to actually go after these straggler trees. Most maps now have straggler trees. They have made some changes to the maps, so this should be an easily achievable task. Okay, there we go. We've got 3 now on gold. My new villager will go to wood. Now, as I'm gathering that wood, as soon as I hit that 50, or right before it actually, I'll send a villager out to the wood line and just have one villager build that lumber camp. It's more efficient than having all of your villagers working on that lumber camp at once. Big thing to remember here, since we are relying on sheep, is you have to do kind of circular scouting patterns. You see I did like a circle here, big circle, circle here, and then I'm going to circle back this way. And then we're going to walk past the town centers, double-click my sheep, and hit S, stop, and look how close they are in. You can even try to get them closer to your villagers, but that's pretty good. Now, you see we're getting close to age-up time. We're going to age up with the Dome of Faith. I like to do this with 4 villagers. I will pull 2 off of gold and 2 off of food. Okay, leave your wood villagers gathering because you're going to need to get those buildings down once you hit the next stage. You see me doing another circle out here, trying to find some sheep. And there we go. We're able to age up just about the 2-minute 40-second mark. Probably do it a little faster if you're not talking like I am. And I'm going to pull 2 off a sheep. And there we go. We got 4 on the Dome of Faith. And that research will be going. And I want to drop down that blacksmith as soon as possible when I hit the next age. Now you see I have 30 wood and I have 3 currently on the straggler tree. I'm going to send my new villager out to build the lumber camp because I know that tree is going to be running out soon. And I'm going to maximize these villager seconds. Now, ideally, I should have built my my mosque a little closer to the tree line, but sometimes it's really hard to get there as fast as possible. I'd rather not be walking and just have a little bit extra time on that technology. So once this is complete, you will want to get the tech in queue. Sometimes this is the one I forget about, honestly. I'm going to use one of my food villagers to build a house once I have enough wood. There we go. Tech takes 2 minutes and 15 seconds. I can even try to connect this with the building here in the second age. And I'm going to go ahead and just move these guys out to the trees just because I don't trust that they'll path to the right spot next. There you go. You do see I need to build a house. I'm actually going to use my food villager to build that house because I want to keep gathering that wood as fast as possible. Okay, so we have 5 on food, 1 on gold. One of these villagers, when it's done, will go back to gold, and one will go to wood. Now, sometimes I move one as the food. It's kind of whatever you're feeling. Okay, so we're doing pretty good with our macro right now. I should have enough wood to drop that blacksmith the second I hit the next age. We're just going to barely get it. Look at that. We're going to age up just before the 4-minute and 30-second mark. And now's a good time to be scouting your opponent, seeing what they're doing, because this can influence what military building you put down. Okay, look at that. Exactly macroed what we need. I'm able to connect this lumber camp now. I'm going to train up that scholar. These villagers are going to go back to food. Okay, so I have 8 on food. All the rest of the villagers will be going to wood. These guys will go to wood after they finish this. And next I'm going to be probably dropping down an archer range in most scenarios. Now, it could be matchup dependent. You know, if you're against French or something, or the Rus are opening with a stable, you might not want to be starting with archers. And here we go. We're going to get siege engineering in queue. So next I'll be dropping down an archer range. Now, sometimes I'll do the archer range first and then a blacksmith. Kind of depends what your agenda is going to be. But this is probably the fastest time to be able to possibly build those rams. And I will actually pull two food villagers to build the archery range once I have that 150 wood, which we do right now. Here we go. Let's pull, that archery range. Here we go. I'm going to put 2 back on the sheep. And I'm scouting, seeing what he's doing. The important thing to do right now is see what units is he training. Does he put a barracks? Does he put an archer range? Does he staple? So you know what to expect, and don't just get blind countered. If he goes double stable, you know, don't make a bunch of archers. Although, honestly, archers still do bad. It's pretty good. I like it steel arrow next, so I just queue these up, followed by iron undermesh, just because it's nice to have those in queue. You don't have an idle. There we go. Now, at this point, you want to eject one of your scholars and put him inside of there. There we go. I'm going to move one of my gold villagers to build a house. I like to use my gold villagers to build the houses in general. I'm going to try to bring these sheep back home. Now, one thing I did forget is you actually want to cancel these and now go into sanctity. Now, you see, it takes a long time to research, so it's honestly not a huge deal. If you know, I missed it for a second because it's going to be a long time till I get this anyways. Basically, I try to take the sacred sites while I start sieging the opponent so that he is busy in his base and I can get some free gold to possibly sneak in and age up. And now I'm going to start rallying these archers across the field. Now, you can either wait to have a little bit of a mass, or you can just start going for it and build your ram. Now, you got to be careful. If he's got horsemen running around, you don't want to be running around in small numbers of archers. But once you get a little mass of archers, you can even pick off those horsemen pretty good. Okay, there we go. Now, I'm going to build my house with my gold villager. And look here. I'm going to have the siege engineering just about a minute. So this will be fine. I've got just enough time to see what's going on in my opponent's base. You know, I could have waited for a bit more of a mass, my archers, if I wanted to. You know, your experience is going to vary. Okay, all new villagers going to wood because we're going to be spamming out a bunch of rams here in just a second. Now, unfortunately, all of his res is basically on the backside of his base. I could try to come over here and poke at his gold, but you know, in this situation, it's about time to build rams. I'm just going to wait another 30 seconds, and rams are going to be in queue. Now, these train really fast. Look, 7 seconds with that efficient production. And sometimes I actually like to put down a second archery range just right away. Now, you can say this is going to delay the fact that I can make a ram. Well, I might be able to build that ram in time. It'll be fine. So add those to the control group. I got 2 archery ranges in 1 control group. I'm going to go ahead and build my house just in advance here. And we'll be able to get this ram in queue. Let's see, about 4 seconds. So right about 7 minutes, 45 seconds, we're going to get our first ram in queue. Now, do know the enemy can usually hear the sound through the fog of war. It's really weird, but they are able to hear this. And at this point, I'm going to be a little bit low on wood since I am producing so many of these archers and rams. And now's a good time. Let's just move that scholar out, get ready to take one of these sacred sites. There we go. Just about 8 minutes, we've got our first ram done, and send that bad boy in. Put him in a control group and watch for villagers. If he pulls villagers, you're drawing that idle time from him, and it's okay. You want to just pick off anything you can. The town center will target the battering ram first. So I would even move up. Sometimes I even build the second ram right underneath his town center after I've sniped out a few units. So you just got to kind of feel it out. And there we go. Look, he's done this, so I might pull off here, go snipe these horsemen. And even though these horsemen are supposed to counter archers, like, look, I'm able to make a quick work out of those, and we'll be just fine. Now, there we go. Look, he's actually pulled villagers to attack my ram, which I wasn't sure if the computer would do. And you see, I'm just able to just micro my archers. I'm going to build a house just before I forget. Now, speaking of things I've forgotten, once you hit the second age, you want to get all of these techs in queue. I just was really focusing on the military build order for you. But I hit F2, it selects all of my military or all of my economic buildings, and then I can tab through them and queue them up. So be sure to get that in queue. I find that almost every game I forget to queue some kind of tech. And obviously, you'll be better at it if you're not talking like I am. And there you go. Look at this. Now, he might pull villagers or whatever. Imagine he's doing it. And I just come up and I take shots at him. And you're going to be in pretty good shape. Now, if he has a bunch of archers, that's okay. His archers aren't going to do damage to you. You can even go after, if he's got his military buildings up front, go after an archer range. Go after barracks. They're easy to pick off. Meanwhile, I hold shift when I hit Q, and it queues up a bunch of them, if you see that. And it's an easy way to just get a bunch of units in queue. But these, of course, are going to train fairly quickly. Now, right now, I've got, two rams. Basically, every time I hit 300 wood, I try to drop down another ram if I can. Now, if you can manage the micro, add an additional lumber camp closer in as your tree line gets cut down. It's going to really help you get plenty, just maximize that villager efficiency. And there we go. We're in a really good situation. Obviously, this is a computer, so not putting up a huge defense, but you get the idea. Now, there could be all kinds of changes to this build. You can do a lot of different things when you get the second age, but I think this is a great option to quickly get to putting a ram in the enemy's base. It might catch them off guard, and you're able to pressure with archers and rams. You could even throw down a barracks second if you really think he's going to have a lot of cav, or two archer ranges then a barracks. You know, whatever variation you want to do, but you get the idea of the strategy. Let me know if you have any ideas for how we can improve the optimization. I'm pretty happy with my timings from going from the Dark Age to the Feudal, instantly getting that blacksmith down, instantly getting the ram technology, siege engineering technology in queue, and I think that is the most important thing with the strategy. And you see there, I finally got my first sacred site just about the 11-minute mark, and I may even here ungarrison some of these and just walk out here just to start getting the gold. And you could age up behind this in case this siege isn't going so well. Pull your units back, kite, just don't overcommit to a fight. And certainly don't let a town center shoot at your archers if a ram is not tanking the damage. So there you go. That's my first Delhi build order post-patch. I think it's going to be a challenging civilization to play in the current balance, but I hope it gives you some inspiration to give them a shot. Let me know what you think down in the comments. And of course, make sure you pick up the build order graphic in the Discord. The link is in the description. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.